Do you like science? How about math, kinematics, physics? Or were you the kid that was sitting in class and only paid attention when it was something car related, whether it would be math or science? Well, you've come to the right place. I'm Giles from Fitment Industries, and today's episode of The Build Sheet, we're gonna be going over what exactly is the center of gravity of your car, why it's beneficial, and how you can use it to your benefit. Before we get into it, don't forget to subscribe, hit that notification button so you get notified when we upload next, and let's just jump into it. When we go ahead and talk about the center of gravity, we're referring to the average location of the weight of an object. This is a location where you could literally suspend an object in space, and in theory, the object should balance out perfectly. Introduced first by our good friend Archimedes way back in the day, center of mass or center of gravity is a very important factor in not only the engineering and design of cool things such as airplanes and rockets and stuff, but also in the cars that we drive every day. The center of gravity is most commonly known as the balance point of an object, but is also known as a few other things, like the point through which a force will cause pure translation and the point at which gravity moments are balanced. Since objects are three-dimensional, the center of gravity is relative to those same three dimensions and is measured using a three-dimensional plane using X, Y, and Z measurements. Gels, why are you telling this to me? Why are you using big words, talking about stuff I never cared about in high school? I'll tell you why. All of the forces that you experience in your car while driving, whether that be diving during braking, rolling through hard corners, or squat when launching or accelerating, are all acting through the center of gravity of your car. The diving, rolling, and squatting that are commonly referred to are known as accelerative forces. And these accelerative forces become more and more apparent when driving a car more aggressively. When cars are designed and developed, engineers take the center of mass or center of gravity into a huge amount of consideration. Vehicles with a higher center of gravity are more prone to weight shift and potentially rollovers if the CG is high enough and a corner is taken too sharp.
Are you alive? Are you alive?
I'm fine, how are you?
Holy that was a hell of a ride!
Trucks and SUVs tend to have a higher center of gravity due to their design, but tend to compensate for it by having a much larger and longer wheelbase. When it comes to the cars that we know and love, they have a much lower center of gravity typically. And what do I mean by lower center of gravity? Like I said before, center of mass or gravity of an object is determined within the three dimensions, X and Y being the horizontal axis and Z being the vertical axis. So when we're referring to a low center of gravity, you're talking about the location along the Z axis. The lower, the better. A lower center of gravity will help keep the car planted to the ground. It also improves handling and responsiveness of the vehicle, reducing the amount of dive, roll, and squat. So you ready for some math? No? Well, here it is anyway. The position of the vertical CG, or center of gravity, height from top to bottom of a car can be determined using the following formula. You take the level wheelbase multiplied by the raised vehicle wheelbase, multiplied by the added weight on the front wheels, and divided by the product of the distance vehicle was raised and overall vehicle weight. What does that exactly mean? I have no idea. Apparently you can find those numbers in like the manual of your car somewhere if you ever wanted to know. Which brings us to the horizontal position. Now the horizontal position of the center of gravity also plays a huge role in the performance of a vehicle as well. Keeping weight towards the center of a car is generally the way to go, as keeping the weight closer to the center of gravity will allow for a lot less polar moment of inertia, which basically means that the car will be a lot easier to move around and will be a lot more responsive. Typically, this is why we see cars with mid-engines. By centralizing a good part of the weight that comes from the engine and transmission and keeping it all together and out from outer parts of the car, it's capable of being a lot more controlled as a whole. Here comes more math. Front to rear location can be determined by the following formula. Rear wheel vehicle weight divided by the overall vehicle weight and multiplied by the wheelbase. And then the side to side position, which is the other horizontal axis, can be determined by this formula. Right side weight divided by the total weight multiplied by the track width. All in all, this has to do with something that is known as moments. At the risk of getting too technical for one video and going an entire lesson on dynamic physics, you can relate this to using a breaker bar on a rusted bolt. Picture the center of gravity as the bolt and the force you're applying as weight. The closer you are to the bolt on the wrench, the harder you're gonna have to pull down on the wrench and the more pressure you're going to have to apply. Now move down the wrench or breaker bar a little bit towards the end and you're not gonna have to use nearly as much force to get the bolt loose. Now, this is what we know as torque or leverage for the most part, but it is synonymous with moment, and it's basically the same principle. So when we pull weight in closer to the center of the car, keep it from being further out, we're reducing the amount of effectiveness or angular displacement that weight would originally have when driving. For the most part, most performance or sports cars right off the market will have considerably low center of gravity right off the bat, usually located near the center of the vehicle with the height sitting right above where the front bumper ends. So like I mentioned earlier, the lower and more central the center of gravity is, the better. And you're probably thinking to yourself, okay, got it. Is there anything that I can do to move it or lower it myself? Glad you asked. Probably one of the easiest ways to lower the center of gravity of your car is, well, lowering your car. Whether it be with lowering springs, coilovers, bags, lowering a vehicle's ride height will at the same time lower the center of gravity on that Z axis. By doing this, you'll get all the benefits of having some sort of aftermarket suspension, plus increased lateral grip. You can also improve vertical center of gravity by removing weight from a car, specifically any weight that sits higher up in a vehicle. You thought you really wanted that sunroof? Would you still want it if I told you that the 25 pounds of weight sitting above your head and at the highest point of the car is drastically affecting your vertical center of gravity? Other things such as carbon fiber replacement panels, especially roofs, can reduce and improve center of gravity as well. As far as going about improving the horizontal center of gravity of a car, it tends to be a little more strategical. Like I mentioned before, moving the weight towards the center of the vehicle is going to be the end goal. Again, we see this achieved with replacement of lightweight body parts such as fenders, hoods, trunks, but also moving around other components such as batteries that will also help with the horizontal position as well. Now, this can all sound very technical and very confusing. You might be sitting there trying to take this all in and be like, man, screw that. That sounds like it takes a bunch of time, a lot of calculations, a lot of math that I don't like doing, and chopping up a car to move things around. And yeah, if you're looking at competing in things like Time Attack or Formula One or something like that, center of gravity is taken into the extremes when it comes to higher end motorsports. But in reality, people like you and people like me, it's really just a matter of keeping a few things in mind when you're going ahead and modifying your car. Keep the car low and keep the weight minimal and localized. Lowering your car will help a ton. Carbon fiber replacement parts look cool and actually do benefit you. Getting seats that sit lower to the floor will help you a ton, and even though it may take a little bit to relocate the battery, it is worth it. So hopefully this gave you a little bit of insight into actually what center of gravity or center of mass of your vehicle actually is, how you can use it to your benefit, and if you're looking to relocate it or modify it a little bit, what you can do to actually do that. Drop a comment down below if you have actually tried to modify or relocate the center of gravity of your car and exactly how you went about doing it. I'm Giles from Fitment Industries. Don't forget to subscribe and wheels, tires, and suspension over at fitmentindustries.com. I'm Giles from Fitment Industries. We'll see you later. Peace.